Let's create topless man. Buff topless man. Okay. What? Why is it appropriate content? Let's go for buff man then.
The woman was too stunned to speak.
Let's try modifying the prompt actually and see whether this gives us. So I've seen the updates that Unity has announced for Unity 6. Some pretty exciting features. To me, the most prominent of these features would be Unity Muse AI, which is gonna be integrated into Unity's engine, and it's gonna be able to understand the context of your project and help you along according to what your project is about, so that then you can just tell the chat what you need. It's gonna understand what your project is about and make suggestions from there. So I'm just gonna be playing around with Unity Muse just to get a sense of how it works and what its strengths and weaknesses. Unity Muse is now available as a 15-day free trial to all users, and after the trial you can choose, if you like it, you can choose to subscribe, and then that will allow you to use Unity Muse for all your projects. So where do you find Unity Muse? So you will find it under muse.unity.com. If you haven't signed up, it's gonna bring you to a different page. So the first thing you will need is to log in to Unity muse.unity.com, and then you will need a version of Unity that is above 2022.3. And I've tried to install Muse on 2020, but it doesn't work. The reason it doesn't work is because after 2020, Unity introduced a new AI system that uses specialized CSS files. They're called USS files, and Unity 2020 and below cannot use those. So once you install Muse, you will find that Muse has a whole bunch of capabilities at this point. Today, we're just gonna try three things: chat, the sprite generation capabilities, as well as the texture generation capabilities. Okay, so we only have one character sprite. So let's try out the sprite generation capabilities of Unity Muse and see how it measures up to other modes of AI image generation, like Mid Journey, or what else do we have? DALL-E, right? So what I'm gonna do is, I've just installed Unity 2022 and I've just upgraded the Vampire Survivors project. So how do you access Muse? If you want to access the chat, then you just have to go to muse.unity.com and then just go to chat. So you will use the sidebar over here like that, and just go to chat and you can ask questions. So right now chat is not integrated with your Unity project, but in the future I believe that's what they have planned. So when you ask a question, you can select a version of Unity that you're using as well. It supports up to 2021, so it looks like for me it's time to upgrade, because I've mainly been using Unity 2019 and 2020 mostly, because 2021 has burst is the new optimization framework that I don't really like because it slows down my project. Okay, so after you have gotten your Muse account, to be able to generate sprites using Muse, you will need to go to Package Manager over here and download the Muse packages. And you will have to open your Package Manager from here and then go to Plus and add the package by name. So you will have to install com.unity.muse.sprite. So this adds the Muse sprite generation package. Let's see how it works. So for every Unity Muse module that you have, or that they have, you can find the instructions to download them under the Muse website after you've logged in. For example, the sprite generator will be under sprite, and then just click on get started. This will bring you to a pop-up that you can follow the instructions of to install that module. Another way you can do this is just to click on install the sprite package, and this will link over to the Unity editor. Alright, but because I've installed the sprite package, I'm not gonna do that. So how do we use the sprite generator? Let's see. Is there an intuitive way for us to use it? That's under AI. So we launch the tool, we install the package, and from the menu we select Muse and Muse Sprite. So if you've downloaded the package correctly, you should find Muse at the top menu bar of your window. So the more modules you have, I assume the more options you will have under the Muse tab. So over here we have, let's just go to Muse and then new sprite generator, and we're gonna have to log in. Let's just play around a bit and see how this works. My guess right away is that this is probably gonna be a little bit less effective than the texture generator. Let's just create new sprites for our character, shall we? Let's create topless man, buff topless man. Okay. I don't know what negative prompts are. Let's just select default, clear the errors. So there are reference images that we can put in. So I don't know if you can guess from this, but what I'm trying to generate is narrow from Rampart's button. So let's find a reference for Muse. Grab his picture, just crop out the sides of the image so that only the gray background is there, right? Gives a better idea to the AI as to what we actually want. We don't want an image with the borders. Drop the image, generate. Why is it appropriate content? Let's go for Bath Man then.
The woman was too stunned to speak.
Well, the sprites don't really work. So this is about as I've guessed, right? That the sprite generator probably is not going to be very good because I've used a couple of AI generation tools and they're pretty hard to use in the sense that it's pretty hard to get the AI to show you what you need and what you want with prompts, and even with a reference image over here, the AI is not giving us something that we can use in our game. So not very context sensitive at the moment. Let's try modifying the prompt actually and see whether this gives us something else. Pixel art of man holding knife. What is this? This guy is not buff, very pixelated though. He's missing feet and he seems to be wearing some kind of headdress. And everything that is generated seems to be pixelated and inappropriate as well. Let's try generating something else, like special effects. How about that? Lightning strike. Let's remove the reference image. Then let's just draw some images and let's see what we get. I'm gonna give it some chance. This is not too bad. Vertical lightning strike or particle effect. So if you're wondering what I'm trying to generate now, I'm trying to generate a texture for one of our videos. We talked about how to create lightning bolts, right? For our lightning ring. So then I got a free texture from Open Game Art. But right now I'm trying to generate a unique texture for it just to test out how the Unity sprite generator works, and it's giving me this, which it's not very usable at the moment. So let's try regenerating this with the improved prompt. Okay, maybe I'm using Muse wrong, but the images that they're giving me are not very usable. The most usable of them probably would be this one. Let's see what happens when we try and save the image. How do we save selected generations into project? So if we save the image, this gives us an option to drop it into one of our folders here. Just gonna save it as Muse Lightning Sprite. And then we'll see how usable this sprite is for particle effects. Just to play around with things, you know? Okay, so let's see how useful this is. The Lightning Sprite. The first thing you'll see is that there's some black at the edges of the image. Not very clear when you open it with some applications with black background. But the black, you have to do something about it, and let me just try and get it away using grayscale, like that. So this removes the black from the image, but it's not very usable for particle effect though. Let me just quickly create a particle effect. So probably you can do something like this with zero speed, and I can just drop the texture over here like that, and I will have to randomize the rotation. And of course reduce the lifetime as well. So this can kind of work as it's kind of like a spell effect. It's not the best, but it kind of works, right? Okay, you can do things with the some generator effects from Muse, but I would say Muse is probably still in its very early stages. But you can generate some decent, you can use the textures or the sprites created to generate some decent special effects if you know what you're doing with particle effects. Let's just play around with Muse and see what else we can get. What if we try and generate a shortwave texture? Style is only default. Let's trash this. Looks like a shortwave, right? Okay, let's see what we get from this. Muse is so self-sabotage. It's just generating effects that it self-deems to be inappropriate. So these are very hard to use. Let's try again. I think as of now, Google will give you better results than Muse. Like if I were to go to Google and if I were to do search for, say, shockwave particle effect texture, I would get better results. See that? Some of these are pretty nice. You just gotta be careful about what effects you pick, because some of them are copyrighted, right? So you wanna find those shortwave particles that are under Creative Commons 0, that's CC 0. But for now, Google gives you better results than Muse, which gives you... Oh my god, what is this? Yep, so probably Muse is still not very well trained. Even Bing, right? If I were to go to Bing and play it for the fine shortwave particle, yeah, even Bing gives us pretty decent results. Again, you just gotta filter out the graphical effects that are copyright free so that you don't get in trouble. So when I'm looking for shortwaves, what I want are things like that. Circular shape with some effects at the edges, so these are good shockwave effects as well. So the shockwave effect usually accompanies, for example, this lightning effect, right? It works very well if I have some kind of a shockwave in the background. So that would be another particle system. Again, there will be no shape and no speed. And then the size will be something like 3. And then what I'll do is just, I'll do a size of a lifetime like that. And emission will be a burst, so something like this. So you'll want to have this kind of shock, this kind of a shockwave, and this can help to express, you know, explosions and whatnot. Then these shockwaves, usually you will want a different texture so that it looks better. So like, for example, you want to have like rings, right? So shockwaves usually accompany, you know, some other effect like an explosion or lightning or something in particle systems. So the textures that Muse generates doesn't really help us very well, because I asked for a shockwave and it gave me monsters like this. But I'm sure they still have a year. I've been using Unity for a while, so you know, I like Unity, so I trust that over the course of the next 9 months before they actually release Muse, they're gonna improve upon it, train the AI better so that it actually produces the results that we need, instead of giving us monsters like these when we try and generate a shockwave particle effect. So my verdict for the sprite generator is, well, it needs more work. We can use it very marginally to generate some particle effect textures. I managed to do one, but then when I tried to do the shockwaves, Google gave me better results than Muse. I expect the texture system will be better. The texture generation module for Muse will be better. Let's try that. So with the texture generation system, same thing, we have to go to window and let's go to package manager. And from here, you can download the Muse texture generation tool. Let's try this out. Same thing, there's prompt, there's negative prompt, and you can put in the texture that Unity can use as a reference. So let's try a sandy beach. 4 images. So the textures are actually not too bad. One thing that we want to check for with textures is whether they are tileable or not. And a simple way to check them would be, let's just download this texture. View as PBR material. What does this do? So this turns the thing into a material so that you can have a look at how it looks in game. Shift and drag to look at the material. Okay, maybe some room for improvement, but at the very least, the texture should be tileable. If I export the texture into project, and if I create a material for this, one quick way to test it out would be to create a new plate like this, and then you can apply the material to this and we can shine some light on it, or we can just turn off lighting and it's pretty tileable. Let me increase the tiling. Yeah, I think the textures are fine. You probably just have to generate on normal to get the textures to be of higher detail, and maybe you have to modify some parts as well. Like there's this dot here in the texture that makes it look very repetitive. But otherwise, I think the texture generator for Muse works much better. Let's try something more exotic for the textures. Let's try maybe futuristic growing platform. So this one perhaps doesn't work that well. So for now, it looks like it's pretty tileable. Let's try this. And again, we're gonna just assign our material onto the, our texture onto the material, and is it tileable? It's not bad, right? I mean, I don't know what this is, but hey, at least it's tileable. It's a basic requirement for the textures that you want to create. And let's give it another more standard prompt. Let's say we go for grass. Oh, this is not bad. Look at this. Not half bad, right? This one. So again, same thing here. You want to make this a texture. Then let's test this out. Probably needs a bit of cleaning up for this one, but it's, again, it's not half bad. It's tileable, see that? I would say the texture generator is pretty usable as compared to the sprite generator, which is just barely usable, barely gives better results than Google and Bing. So even with search engines, right, if I were to search for that same thing in Google, well, I actually get pretty decent results as well. So some would say it's better, but one problem that Google images have with textures is that the image is not tileable, meaning if you were to put in a texture, you will see that it's clearly disjointed. Let me just show you an example, right? If I were to grab this texture, for example, so if I apply this into the material that we have, see that it's not tileable? You can see the obvious squares. So I would say in this aspect, the Muse AI generator does a good job with the textures that it generates, because at the very least, even though the AI has trouble understanding prompts, like I asked for sandy beach and I got dirt, but you know, it gives me images that are tileable, you don't see clear squares, which is a big plus. So what is my verdict on the texture generator? It's much more usable than the sprite generator. And well, Muse is still in its very early stages. So given how fast AI is advancing, I would say probably in a couple of months, maybe give it 3-4 more months and we come back to Muse, it may just have become much better. The texture generator, of course, there's going to be more stuff that's going to come up. Maybe it's going to generate normals for you as well, like if you download textures in Polyhaven. It comes with normals and it comes with roughness and all kinds of maps that make it so that you are able to create textures with very high detail. So as of now, if you want to use the AI texture generator, you actually would be better off finding a texture inside Polyhaven. Gives you much better results, but the AI generator is getting somewhere. If you want something unique, the AI generator can probably give you something unique. But you probably have to use some application, like one application I like to use is the normal map generator from GitHub that converts any texture into a normal map, and then it gives you a preview of how the object actually looks like. So the texture generator is going somewhere, but you know, the sprite generator has a lot more work that needs to be done to it. So with that said, I hope you enjoy looking at me generate these images.